How does a child learn language and acquire vocabulary as it develops? Imagine that you wanted to answer this question. How would you go about collecting data and designing a research study to do that? That's today's topic, and it's covered under textbook chapter one. We're going to look at different ways in which psychologists collect data and try to answer their questions, like the ones we just posed. We're also going to look at some other perspectives of ways of explaining human development, in addition to the ones we looked at last time. So, you want to know how a toddler learned their first words, for example. You could study a particular toddler or infant in detail. Perform a case study. That's a way of collecting data descriptively. You could give them assessments, say a test to know how many words they know, how frequently they use it, etc. Another descriptive way of collecting data is through surveys. So, for example, you could survey several different parents and ask them, how many words does your toddler know? How often and what context do they use it? Finally, you could also just naturalistically observe this child. So you could sit in through, say, a one-way mirror and look at a child or different children in their natural environment and see how they use words and how often. So those are some ways that you could answer your question descriptively. There are many famous case studies in developmental psych, including Jeannie, the feral child, who we'll talk about later, Phineas Gage in neuroscience, HM for memory, etc., etc. Another famous researcher who used this particular descriptive method, case studies, is Erik Erikson. And he espoused a particular view of answering questions in human development, the psychodynamic perspective in his psychosocial stages theory. So the basic question here, in this perspective, is what are the needs of people at different stages of their lives? What are their challenges? Are the needs of an infant the same as the needs of an adolescent or an adult? Are the challenges that they face the same? You would probably say no, they're different. So for Erik Erikson, he tried to look at some internal psychological challenges that we face, as well as external social ones, psychosocial challenges at each stage of our lives and how we overcome them successfully, hopefully, to move on to the next stage. He looked at the basic trust challenge that we face as an infant. So right now, with my little one, I tried to give him a sense that the world is a good, safe place, that when he needs to be changed or fed or comforted, I am there to provide that basic trust. If he develops that, he will go on to the next stage, according to Erikson, of autonomy, meaning that he will realize that he is an individual who can make personal decisions. If you've ever observed a child from 1 to 3 years old, you'll know that they learn the word no very quickly. They realize that they have a say in the world, as opposed to developing shame and doubt. According to Erikson, if this is successfully resolved, we go on then well-equipped into the next stage to take initiative, to develop the ability to do things on our own, to get the cookie in the cookie jar if we want it, even if that means breaking a few things along the way, right? After this stage, we then go on to developing skills, industry. This is school-aged children from 6 to 11 years old or so, where we learn basic language, math skills, we learn social skills, etc., etc. We play in the playground and we become more and more of developed human beings. We go on to many other stages, which you can read about in your textbook: identity, intimacy in adolescence and young adulthood, etc., etc. We will cover these stages in the course. But here I want to emphasize that Erik Erikson used case studies to develop this theory. He looked, interviewed, assessed individuals in close detail to be able to come up with this theory. But that's not the only method that we use. Those are descriptive and observational methods. We also, as psychologists, use what we call correlations. So how are two factors related? For example, is TV violence, watching violence on TV, related to aggression in childhood? A study tried to answer that very question, which was published in the Developmental Psychology Journal in 2003, and they did find a correlation that children who regularly watch violent TV are more likely to become aggressive and criminal in adulthood. Correlations can be positive. That doesn't mean good. It simply means that two things are related in the same direction. For example, as your study skills increase, so do your course grades. This is a positive correlation, as opposed to a negative correlation. Again, not meaning bad, but simply that two things vary in opposite directions. So for example, as your socioeconomic status increases, how well off you are, your malnutrition decreases. They are negatively related. Finally, there are things that are not correlated at all or have a zero correlation. For example, playing video games is not correlated, is not associated with your math skills. Correlations do not tell you whether something causes something else. For that, we need experiments. So within that, we look at variables that impact outcomes, independent variables and dependent variables. You're invited to watch the Albert Bandura's Bobo doll experiment, which looked at trying to answer the question, how much do we learn by simply observing others? So this is a social learning perspective. And within that, he did an experiment looking at the independent variable of exposure to an aggressive or non-aggressive model. So a child looked at an adult being aggressive or not, and the dependent variable of the child's behavior. Did watching an aggressive model make the child likely to become more aggressive, him or herself? That is the gist of Albert Bandura's Bobo doll experiment, which you should watch on your web links section of the course shell. That is what we have for today. You should be able to perform all of these objectives for this lecture, and then go on and do your discussion for this particular topic, which is under week 3, and you will find it on the call-out button entitled Your Research Design, Erickson's Psychosocial Stages. Catch you on the next screencast.